Good afternoon. Now that I've taken a detour and got Jacobians for radial to polar coordinate systems and vice versa, I'd like to continue my earlier project of asking questions like, what is equation 1? What is equation 2? And now we're ready for what is equation 3? Equation 3 is given 32 minutes into Dr. Physics A's used YouTube video, Einstein Field Equations for Beginners, and I think it's given in this form here. V sub y sup n equals the sum over m del y n del x superscript m v sub x superscript m. Now I'm going to make a little change to this formula. And you'll notice that I have two options for the change, depending on whether I do Jacobian first or vector first. So I'll copy the equation first, and then, actually, it's not going to work quite that easily, because whereas Einstein notation at least seems to be commutative, matrix multiplication is definitely not. So I'm going to take an additional step of moving this over here and moving the whole thing that way. Then I don't have to think too much because it's written right up above, because what I'm going to do with the v sub y, n is going to go here. Well, it's going to be based on what's going on over here. What I want is to be able to multiply something like this, so that's right, so that has to be down. The going to the right has to be on the left-hand side, the going down, the indices down has to be to the right. Over here, we're going to have the m matches the m here, so we'll have to have this m going to the right and this m going down, and this m to the right is going to match the n going to the right over here, and the n going down over here is going to match the n going to the right over here. Or rather, basically this vector has to have the same shape as this vector, and this vector has to have the same shape as this vector. Now, I would not stop here. If I was doing, I wouldn't even go into the figuring out what 1 and 2 and 3 is. I would probably just start with making my mapping, say x is x comma y, and y, I shouldn't put those in different places, but y is r comma theta, and then actually just use those variables in place of that. So in that case, I would write v sub x, or y is vr theta, so v sub r, v sub theta, going down, v sub r, v sub theta, going down, equals, and then this del yn. It's another little shortcut you can use when making up the Jacobian, which is to do the del x first, del, and this is del x, x is x and y, del x, del y, and then the y is coming down, which is r and theta, and then put the v sub x, the mx coming down, so x coming down is x, y. V sub x, V sub y. V sub x, V sub y. And crash and burn. That's what you get for not testing this. This thing is not right. What is it supposed to be? It's supposed to be this. Del r theta down del x y across. And so, essentially, it's the outer product of something, but I put the outer product in the wrong order. It would have been, and it's, well, how do I put this, is an outer product of r theta and del del r, del del x, del del y. And when I do that, the thing is, there's nothing about doing the partial derivative that says, that the derivative comes before the r. I don't know if that makes sense. Think of reverse Polish notation or something like that. You put in the number 30, and then you take the sign afterwards. But you always write sign after it. I could write the x squared and then take the sign of that. Even though we actually write del del x of x squared, there's nothing in particular that says that we didn't actually have the x squared first and then take the operator of that afterwards. So, anyway, this notation is awkward for matrix multiplication but it does produce the result del r del x del r del x and del r del y del theta del x and del theta del y. It's an outer product of these two things. Okay, so I did that that way. Let's pull it from this part of the equation. I'm going to copy that down again. See if we can have similar amount of success, or hopefully even less confusion this time. This time I'm going to write, again, y is r theta, so this is v sub r theta to the right. This is v sub x, y, y is r theta, and we'll be going to the right with that. I neglected to put the arrow in there earlier, and this is going to be going to the right. This is going to be going to the right, and xy going down. And so we'll be taking v sub r theta going to the right, so that'll be v sub theta equals v sub xy, which is v sub x, v sub y times this time we could actually comfortably write del x, del y, and r theta, and make that an outer product again. It'll be, I'll just copy this down again and fill in that matrix, del r, del x, del theta, del x, del y, del theta, del r. It is difficult to make a good video when you're not a perfectionist, but I will keep trying. Del r, del y, del theta, del y. That will be better. Now, if you know anything about taking the transpose of a transpose of a product of matrices, you'll notice that if I have A equals B, C, and I want to get A transpose, I need to take C transpose times B transpose. So in this case, we'll find that V sub R, V sub theta, which is the transpose of V sub R, V sub theta, that way, will be the transpose of this, which is del R del X, del theta del x will come down this way, and then del r del y and del theta del y will come down this way, then we'll multiply that by v sub x and v sub y coming over here. Now, what is equation 2 compared to equation 3? What is this new equation 3 compared to equation 2? It's actually just a more general version of what equation 2 was. Equation 2 had exactly the same form, but it was del phi, the v sub r, the vector v sub r, v sub theta, would have been del phi del, wait. It was a specific thing. It was a scalar, and we were taking the gradient of the scalar, which would be del phi del r, del phi del theta, was equal to all this. And then that was multiplied by del phi del x and del phi del y. So all this is was that equation 2 is a specific case of equation 3. Equation 2 was the gradient of a scalar field. Equation 3 is just any vector field. So to review, let's check if these bold statements are correct. Equation 1 was just to explain what a gradient field was. Equation 2 tells us how to find a gradient field in an alternate coordinate system. For instance, if you're given vx, vy, you want, or I'm sorry, the gradient del phi del x, del phi del y, we want to get it in del phi del r, del phi del theta. Equation 3 tells us how to find any vector field in an alternate coordinate system. So if we have vx, vy, we can get it vr, v theta. So the only one of these that I'm not completely certain of here is just what equation 1 was, because I last looked at that a few days ago. Okay, now looking at it again, is equation 1 telling us what the gradient is? The gradient is this del phi del x of n. No, it's assuming we already know what the gradient is, because it's using it to tell us what the change in the scalar field is. D phi equals the gradient of phi dot producted with the differential path element. So let's go back to my bold statements and correct them. Equation 1, control C, control V. Equation 1 used a dot product of the gradient field and the differential path element to describe a differential change in a scalar field. Okay, fantastic. So let's go on to the next obvious question. What's equation 4? But I'm going to save that for yet another video.